Hello everyone, welcome to Beaver's Hobby Channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make a simple light kit for RC car using NiMh TRQ1 to demonstrate. Before we begin, I have to tell you that you'll have to do some soldering, but don't worry, light kit is fairly easy to make. I'm not going to cover how to do soldering in this video, but I have a link to a soldering comic book in the description below, so you can read it if you want. With that out of the way, let's begin with the things you need. First, the plug. This is a simple light kit, so choose a plug that's not in use on your car. If you use balance plug to power the car, like WL Toys and Atomic, you can use this red JST plug for the light. If you use pretty much any other ESC, then it'll use the JST and you'll have the balance plug left. A normal balance plug for 2-cell LiPo is JST-XH 2.5mm 3-pin. As for TRQ1, we can use the auxiliary port right here, which is a bypass from the battery. The plug is JST-PH 2mm 2-pin. Next, some LEDs. The light kit is for 1/20th scale car, so I'll use 3mm LEDs, 2 white and 2 red. Next, some resistors to limit the current going to the LEDs so they won't burn. I'll show you how to calculate the resistor you need later. And finally, some wires and heat shrink. Now let's find the resistor you need. First, you have to know the voltage and the current of the LED. You can usually find the specification for the LED on the website that you buy it from. As you can see here, each color runs on different voltage, so you'll have to calculate the resistor for each color separately. Next thing to know is the battery voltage. You should use the fully charged voltage, as shown on the screen. If you just want to know which resistor to use, head over to this website, input the LED data and how many you are going to use, and it'll tell you the resistor you need. But if you want to calculate it yourself, start from the Ohm's Law, V equals I times R. And here's the formula. Battery voltage minus LED voltage divided by the current going through the LED. If you have more than one LED in parallel, providing all of them are the same, multiply the current by number of the LEDs. And if you have more than one LED in series, again, providing all of them are the same, multiply the LED voltage by number of the LEDs. And normally, the current will be in milliamp, so you'll have to multiply it by 0.001 to calculate. A proper way to do this is to use one resistor with one LED. But I am going to use one resistor with two LEDs in parallel, because I'm certain each LED has roughly the same spec and I want to save space in the car even if it is just a little. White and red lights are running on different voltage, so I'll separate them to different resistors. This is the result from the formula I told you earlier, and because the calculation rarely matches the existing resistors, you'll have to use the nearest higher rated resistor instead. For me, they are going to be all 100 ohm resistors. I also calculate some more combinations for you in the description. Check them out if you use 2-cell LiPo battery or 1-cell LiPo battery. If you have a breadboard, you should use it to check the circuit and brightness. I ended up using 100 ohms for white light and 200 ohms for red light, so the back is a bit less bright than the front. And here's the diagram. Before I go any further, let's check the polarity of this plug with multimeter. So now I know that left is negative and right is positive. Next, it's time to do the soldering. Remember, long leg on the LED is positive and the short leg is negative. Resistor can go before or after the LED, and I choose to put it before. Just wire everything together according to the diagram and make sure the polarity is correct. Positive on the plug to resistors. Red LEDs to 200 ohm resistor. white LEDs to 100 ohm resistor. All negative to negative on the plug. Finally, cover the joist with heat shrink. And that's it. Here we have a light kit for TRQ1. Unfortunately, the body doesn't have slots for rear lights, so I'll have to drill them in with 3mm drill bit. Now put the lights in. I use hot glue to hold them in. Then use electrical tape to hold the wires. And it is done. Plug it in. Turn the car on. And here it is. And that's it for this video. Please subscribe if you want to see more content like this. And hit the bell icon to get the notification whenever I upload a new video. You can follow me on Facebook or social media for quick updates, written reviews, news, and see what I'm doing between videos. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time.